Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. We now have this new patch installed, which is supposed to stabilize things. Fix character animations. Eyes are supposed to look better, things like that. Right, I left off here. But I don't even have to, I can just fast travel. The Tempest? Yeah. Ta-da! Because we're going back up into the Tempest, and then we're going back into onto the Nexus. Okay, stand by my... Okay, I can't turn. It's a side stop working. Hold on a second, guys. Well, I don't want to do extraction. I just want to get out. I can't turn the Nomad. That's interesting. I thought it was my tactical board, but I can turn with my character. So... Okay. I never changed this. I wonder what else has changed, but I don't want to mess with everything while you guys are watching. Now we can turn. So, you know what would be cool? If we could actually... drive right up into the Tempest, but I don't think it works like that. Whee! Okay, let's... extraction.
Ascent is go.
Cool.
Leaving Atmo. All clear.
Now I know we have to come back here, but I'm glad to be done for now.
Before the meeting gets started, I have bunk assignments for Peebee and Drac.
Cool.
Already put my rucksack in the kitchen. I'll hang out there if that's okay.
Sleep in
then
the kitchen?
I'm in one of the escape pods. More my speed. That's fantastic. Welcome aboard. Any thoughts, Ryder?
Oh, now we've got... okay. We've got hotkeys if you don't want to move your mouse around and stuff. That's funny, though. We cleared out bunks for them, and they're going to go sleep in the kitchen in an escape pod. Yeah, whatever. It's cool.
I don't care where anyone sleeps, as long as we realize what a kick-ass team we have.
Yeah.
Let's talk about our success on Eos. Besides establishing our first viable outpost, we did some amazing things.
Mm-hmm.
We discovered the Remnant and breached their vault.
That was awesome.
And didn't get killed.
Overcame radiation poisoning a number of times.
Sorry,
and didn't
guys.
Die. Confronted by Ket at every turn.
Once again, did not get killed.
You guys really need to raise the bar on what you call success.
Not death.
Yeah, should we use the Krogan definition of success that got your homeworld nuked by your own people?
What?
Fair enough.
Why bring that up?
Let's focus. Back to the task at hand.
She's vicious.
Looking forward.
Exactly. Here's my only question. When do we hit that next vault? It looked active. We have to get on that.
Hang on, hang on.
We need to not go off half-cocked.
There are initiative priorities. The team calls the shots.
Actually, the Pathfinder calls the shots, just to be clear.
Yeah, thanks.
So what do you need from us, Ryder?
Well, quite a motley crew we have here, no less motley than in the other games. So we have another vault on that planet or on another planet? Because I don't remember talk of that. Let's just get along.
Let's be kind and give each other the benefit of the doubt. Finding a home for tens of thousands in this hellscape is stressful enough without adding dysfunction.
You're here.
You got it, boss.
Huh. Croy didn't think much of that, huh?
If Krogan are known for one thing, it's getting along.
Oh,
but not humility or self-awareness.
Okay, let's head back to the Nexus. PB, Drac, see Lexi for a physical? Good meeting, everyone.
They listen so well. Good, so we do get to look around. Yeah, okay. Augmentations? Well, brings us right to... Okay, tutorials. Yeah, alright. I'm gonna have to refer to this later. I guess there's nothing new here to look at. At least not up there.
A secure outpost. Finally.
Prodromos better be worth all that time Ryder put into it.
If they fail, the Nexus starves. No pressure, right?
So everything we do now relies on civilians planting vegetables.
Rishi. Are they talking over comms or something? I guess so.
So we have a stowaway.
You mean Peebee?
She's decided to set up in one of the escape pods.
Yep.
You don't need a psychologist to tell you that one's got commitment issues.
Huh. Really? How do you think the morale is here?
How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality. Anyone in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
How about the human crew?
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Okay. How about Cora?
How's Cora doing?
She's processing. Your father was her mentor. She expected to follow in his footsteps, but he gave the role of Pathfinder to you.
Sure
Just
did.
Because she trusts his judgment doesn't mean she's not confused. Or hurt.
Hmm. So this is the voice of, what's her name, who plays Marjorie on, or who played Marjorie on, Game of Thrones. No spoilers for Game of Thrones. what about Gil?
Gil?
Gil likes to use humor as a defensive technique. He'd rather bury himself in the Nomad than tackle emotions head on.
Hmm. Suvi?
Suvi okay?
She's remarkably adaptive. I'm kind of jealous.
And Liam?
How's Liam?
A handful. Every time I patch him up, he breaks something new.
Hmm.
Liam's we can't lose attitude is commendable. But I worry how he'll react when something does go wrong.
Really? Well, that'll be interesting. He's gonna freak out. What about the non-human crew?
I'd like to check in on the non-human crew.
Ask away.
Peebee?
Is Peebee all right?
She's avoiding me. Probably thinks I'll poke her with a needle if she gets too close.
Yeah.
To be fair, you're always giving me shots.
Not in the hallway.
And Vetra?
Tell me about Vetra.
Vetra's used to having someone depend on her.
Hmm.
I think that's why she's so resourceful and likes providing for other people. That being said, I think she could use a little me time.
She's got that kick-ass attitude too, though. And Kallo?
How's our Solarian?
He's quite the gossip. Tight-lipped about himself, though.
Hmm. And Drac?
Is Drac good?
That old bastard's always good.
Hmm.
I've never met anyone who can be so stubborn and so appreciative. Could you look out for him, Ryder?
Sure.
Don't worry, Lexi. I'll keep an eye on him.
Thank you. And maybe don't mention I asked.
Okay. I'll check on in everyone.
Thanks for the insight. How do you think the crew is holding up?
I'm happy to share what I can without violating patient confidentiality.
There's something here.
Anyone
that...
in particular? I sort them in their files and my brain by species.
Sorting method.
Why do you sort them that way?
Just easier for me to see patterns in behavior.
Alright.
How do you think the human crew members are handling things?
There's a lot of them.
Thanks for the insight.
How did you become a doctor?
How did you get into medicine?
My mom was a dancer on Omega. Dad was a bouncer. I'd patch him up after busy nights. Discovered I had steady hands. They put every credit they earned into my education.
Are they here in Helios?
No. Both died in a turf war. Made leaving the Milky Way behind easier.
Well, sorry to hear that.
I'll let you get back to it.
I'll be here if you need me.
Now this console, well, that's the research station. I'm not going to mess with that right now. I'm looking for the strike team missions because some of these have probably expired. We've been down on the planet for quite a while. Identify the spy. Completed. So... mission successful. Level gained. So who's the spy? So now we only have these missions? Yeah, we had a whole list before. Oh wait, now there's more. Expires in 16 hours. 16 hours. About acquire enemy research. An enemy group is performing medical research that's yielded some promising and dangerous results. Infiltrate the facility and get us that research. 10 mission funds, loot boxes. Send a strike team. Start mission. How many teams do I have? Can I do another one? I guess not, because it's not letting me. Alright. This is a long mission. Okay.
You have new email at your terminal, Pathfinder.
Oh, thank you. Sam, I am. Let's check in on the bridge.
Those remnant vaults, all those secrets. Have to go exploring in one someday.
Yeah, you should come with us.
Flying through one. Now that would be a real hazard course.
Flying through one?
Scans of the Scourge. All that dark energy twisting and turning on itself. It's splendid.
It does have beauty.
I suppose it is a rather darkly beautiful phenomenon. Darkly beautiful.
I like that. Huh. Helios is incredible, isn't it? Not just constructs like the Scourge and the Remnant Vaults. Just all of it. So alien. A constant reminder of the divine intelligence behind all creation.
Mm. She does look a little better. Especially her eyes. So, divine intelligence? A god?
You mean a god?
Yes, I believe in a higher power. I know it's a little odd.
I can't move that.
But I am a scientist because science brings me closer to something greater than myself.
I feel the same way.
There's something about coming face to face with something wondrous that makes you want to believe.
Wow. It's wonderful to meet someone who understands. I've had to justify myself so often. As if having faith in the divine invalidated my work as a scientist. As if this sacred could be diminished by the search for truth.
Her hair still bothers me, though. We should chat more on this.
You definitely have an interesting perspective on the interplay between faith and science. I'd really like to pick your brain on that sometime. Maybe over drinks? Nexus?
Now we're talking.
I'd like that. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports.
Okay.
Talk later. Now I should probably update the rest of the team with my latest reports. We'll talk later.
Okay. So at that point, right after we'll talk later, the game crashed. But now we're okay. Maybe because I was running Firefox at the same time, uploading another video. Possibly.
Hello, Gil. When are you cleaning up that repair on the sensor console?
I'm not. It's a redesign.
A redesign? Without a trained crew?
I'm trained and it's working great. Don't be so uptight.
Everything okay?
Oh, fine. Fine. Don't worry about it.
Are you sure?
What can I do for you?
Are you and Gil fighting?
I couldn't help overhearing you and Gil. It sounded pretty heated.
He likes redesigning things, but the ship was built this way for a reason. I wish Gil would respect that. It's nothing to concern yourself about, really.
What's your opinion on the others?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Well, I can't talk about Suvi. She's sitting right there.
I'm not listening. You can say whatever you like.
Huh? Oh no, I'm not falling for that again.
You're only gonna talk about Suvi?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I'll admit it. Gil's rather irritating. He insists on redesigning systems rather than maintaining them.
He likes to do things his way.
That doesn't make it the right way.
So is this random? I just have to keep hitting this?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Liam's quite fun. Not many humans have that kind of energy. I probably shouldn't have told him there are secret compartments in the armory, though. He's been looking all day.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Dr. Tapero seems nice, if quiet. It must be very different here, compared to the Hyperion. Fewer people in stasis shock.
Let's keep it that way.
True.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Given Drax's history with Salarians, it's probably better I just stay out of his way. Too bad. That grunion roast he makes smells delicious.
Grunion roast, huh?
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I like Peebee. But I really hope she doesn't lean on the escape pod's manual release by accident.
Is that easy to do?
It's an escape pod. If it's difficult to use, you're doing it wrong.
True again.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Vetra's very kind. She actually got hold of some dried seaweed snacks for me. Said I needed feeding up.
I love those seaweed snacks.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
I don't talk to Cora much. She always seems so busy. There are things I'd like to ask her about your father, but it never seems like a good time.
I think we're about out of people.
What do you think of the rest of the crew?
Oh, if I gossip anymore, I'll get in trouble.
I'll let you concentrate.
You know where I'll be.
Okie dokie. What's in here again?
You're setting up in here,
Peebee.
Huh?
Yeah, I'm going through what we got out of that vault. If I can crack this data storage box, it'll help with a personal project back on the Nexus. This is a nice out-of-the-way place where I can tinker, and I can sleep anywhere. It's not exactly homey, but I like that about it. not really looking for a home. Oh, but I will help you find everyone a home. While I'm with you, at least.
You're not sticking around?
Should I consider you a temporary addition? Everything's temporary, Ryder. I get it. You want to know who's on your ship, so you're here to figure out what makes me tick, right?
Something like that? Sure.
Well, I was born in a log cabin on rural Haitiana, to simple but loving parents, just trying to... I look forward, not back, Ryder. Why snooze through my life story? Get to know me out in the field, while we're uncovering the mysteries of this galaxy.
Okay.
That's why I'm here. Got tired of yawning back home.
You crave excitement, huh?
Tackling complete strangers in the Milky Way wasn't doing it for you?
I think tackling you anywhere would be fun. Did I say that out loud? Life won't be boring with you around. I may never yawn again.
That's so funny. So boredom drove you here then?
You left everything and everyone you knew because you were bored?
No. I came with someone I knew. Then she got bored with me. Ryder, the Milky
Way seems possible.
Been there, done that. Even if I hadn't done it, someone had. If there's one thing you should know about me, it's that I live for the unknown. For the never been done.
Then that's all I need to know.
Well, congratulate yourself. No one has ever so successfully dodged my attempts to get to know them.
Yes! I'm number one! Buy me a drink sometime. Who knows what will spill out of my mouth. Then again... I need remnant scrap. Remtech, I call it. For projects like the one I mentioned. Which you're gonna love, by the by. Promise to bring me what you scrounge, and I'll submit to all your questions.
Well, you'll submit.
Remtech, huh? You got it.
Too funny. Anything else to say?
You again. Want to hear more about my childhood log cabin?
Is there anyone special besides the person who got bored of you?
You mentioned you came to Andromeda with someone.
Nothing gets by you. Guess that's why you're the Pathfinder. Just a friend. Now she's not even that. It's better to venture into the unknown without restraints or entanglements, don't you think?
Sounds lonely.
I don't know. Don't friends and loved ones make all the effort worthwhile?
I've always been self-motivated. Don't need much more than curiosity to drive me forward.
So what do you think of the Nexus?
What was it like for you on the Nexus?
Well, I wasn't supposed to be woken up yet. That ex-friend I mentioned, my accomplice, she finagled my early thaw. So I kind of lived off the grid. Snuck around, bullshitted my way onto excursions off station. After I found my first remnant ruin, I started, borrowing shuttles. After that, I didn't spend much time on the Nexus. I even missed most of the revolt.
Flirting?
What does someone have to do to get you to flirt with them?
Not much at all. But I get a little extra jolt when I'm matched wink for wink. So just be yourself and the flirts will flow.
The flirts will flow. Okay. Well, we got a live one over here. What's your current project?
You really won't tell me what you're working on?
That's right. Next question.
Okay. The remnant.
What drew you to the remnant?
Are you kidding? It's evidence of a sophisticated species no one knows anything about. It doesn't get more intriguing than that. There's so much to discover. I want to be the first to figure them out. And the tech, it's on a different scale. If we can appropriate it, who knows what advances we'll make.
Okay, what do you think of the Tempest crew?
So, how do you like the team?
Interesting bunch. I get a good feeling from Vetra. Not your typical military-minded Turian.
No, she's
Liam
cool.
Liam seems a lively one. I expect he'll surprise me. Drek is, well, old. Wonder if he can still learn new tricks.
What about
Gil smacks of complication. Might take some unraveling. Kallo and Suvi seem busy. I hope they aren't all work, work, work. Who's left?
Well, there's...
Oh, right. Cora. What's her deal? Is she as prim and proper as she comes across?
Cora's a professional.
She's exactly what she should be. Capable, reliable. She's a valuable part of my team.
Sure, sure. That comes across too.
There's also Lexi, our doctor. She's an Asari.
Oh, I'll get around to her. All in all, seems like a decent bunch.
Oh, get around to her. Okay. See ya.
You're off the hook, Peebee. Good luck with your project.
Thanks. Don't be a stranger.
Now we could go back and talk to these people more. Can we talk to Suvi more? Oh, there's an email terminal. I have to look at that. I didn't even know that was there.
I saw pictures of the vault. Astounding how big it is. And how much of it didn't you see? What if it's way bigger? What's all that space for?
Parties?
Wild remnant parties? What else would you use it for?
Oh, Ryder, you're adorable.
Aw, shucks. Ah! Okay, so I'll tell her I like her.
I'm really glad you volunteered to join our crew, by the way.
I am too. You galaxy and all. I'm honored to be here.
I'll tell her she's cute.
No, I mean... I think you're cute and I like seeing you up here.
Oh my goodness, Ryder!
I just blurted
also,
it out.
The accent. The accent is... I mean, it's not the only thing, but... Okay, I should just go over there to the piloting thing.
Kill me now.
Ryder, thank you. And so you know, the feeling's mutual.
Yes. Aww.
I mean, time to pathfind. Serious business. Saving everyone.
My god, a little awkward, huh?
Anything I can help with?
Tell me more about your faith.
When did you start believing in a god?
My parents were both scientists. My home was ruled by rationality. So when I became a teenager, let's just say that while other kids found Batarian music, I found God.
But your work as a scientist
Batarian
convinced
music?
Me even more, especially when I got into molecular biology, physics. The patterns I kept seeing over and over again, they were like an artist's watermarks. God, to me, is an artist, an inventor, not someone checking to see if I brush my teeth.
Hmm. And what do you think about terraforming?
What do you know about the Remnant's terraforming network?
From what I can tell, the vault is designed to adjust almost everything about a planet. Climate, pH of the soil, atmosphere composition. There's even evidence that it can propagate life. If we can figure out how to control the vaults, we could turn these worlds into perfect habitats.
True. Well, we figured out how to control one of them. Mostly. Kinda.
I should get back to things.
Sounds good.
Oh, emails. Oh, we got a bunch. Heartfelt thanks to Ryder from Dr. Aradana. The families of my heartfelt thanks, by the way, is the topic, subject. The families of my lost expedition asked me to convey their appreciation to you for finding their loved ones. It's always difficult when we lose people, but knowing what happened will help them begin the mourning process. I hope your next excursion has a happier ending. Aradana. Yeah, we'll see. Oh, another one. Asking for assistance from Aradana. Hello, Ryder. Forgive the intrusion. I have an issue that you and Sam should be able to readily solve. It may assist my investigations into the Scourge. We can discuss it in person at the Nexus Labs. My regards to you and Sam. Dr. Aradana, Astrophysics Lead, Nexus Tech Labs. Reminder. From Cora. Thanks for talking. Things feel better, although they don't feel fixed yet. Remember to take time for yourself, too. Work's important, but so is time to grieve. Grief and fear cannot rule you. Let them be your faithful servants, protective of their mistress. Loss serves a huntress like fuel serves fire. Estheris, 12 Leaves, verse 132. What is that from? Cora. P.S. Plants are coming along. Sam and I are learning about botany together. Interesting times. That vault. Again from Cora. Can still smell that remnant vault on my armor. A lot of weird shit down there, like my huntress manuals would say, the razor's edge between known and unknown teaches you what can be cut away. Now I think back, it reminded me a little bit of some of the temples on Thessia. Same huge spaces and running water, quote-unquote. Same sense of a huge purpose that you can't really understand. Makes me wonder if we'll ever know what their builders did there. Cora. Tempest hacks. From Kallo. Hello, Ryder. I am pleased to report that the Tempest is operating at peak efficiency. So now that you're in command, I thought I'd share a few secret shipboard hacks that the designers and I sneaked into her code. Just enter the code JCSB through your Omni tool to open the debug command menu. Do I have to write this down? JCSB? What does that stand for? Give all to Spen. Lets you use the coffee dispenser in the galley an unlimited number of times. Water temp override. Overrides the normal hot water ration in the showers. Jump wash queue. Puts your clothing ahead of everyone else's in the auto laundry cycle. Enjoy, and don't share them around. Kallo. Proud to be here. From Liam. Hey, Pathfinder. Just hitting this point again. Our team? No place I'd rather be. Here's where we get to fix things. Soon as we have people on the ground, I'll have eyes on how to get them what they need. This sort of just make it happen is why I joined HUST1 and exactly why I came here. We'll do it. Costa. Liam has included a list of media themed to Frontiers. Media themed to Frontiers. Genres include Western space operas and, oddly, Turian historical dramas. Oh my god, so many emails. What? You're the boss. From Vetra. Pathfinder, I thought I ought to clarify. I know I said something about back channels, doing what I have to do. Being on the Nexus during the bad times, a lot of us got used to a lot of ugly things, because survival just isn't that pretty. But in the end, I'm here to help you. So if there's anything you don't like, I won't do it. Simple as that. Vetra. Okay. My paper. From Suvi. Dear Ryder, I've attached my paper on Helios soil in case you were looking for some light bedtime reading. Once again, I'm honored to be here, Suvi. Server message, the attachment heliospedology sanwar.ait has been categorized as spam and is now quarantined. Spirituality from Suvi. Dearest Ryder, I'm so happy we talked earlier. Well, she typed this up quickly. You won't believe how often I've had to defend myself and my feelings to other people. You reveal one thing about yourself, and people immediately assume other things about you. I can believe in a higher power and still do science. It's like I can wear more than one hat. No, actually more like wearing more than one watch. I can do that, and it makes me even less likely to be late. That was weird. I traded Gil some chocolate so I could try his homemade ale. It's strong. Suvi. Okay, so I read the dad about your dad. No, I didn't. Okay, I must have hit that by mistake. From Drac. Vetra told me what happened to your dad. I've lost a lot of people over the years. Figured you could use some cheering up. Or at least a distraction. This usually helps me. Drac has attached 37 images of various rifles and shotguns. 2 are duplicate images. Many are low-res or watermarked. Drac. In case you're interested. From Lexi. Attachment. Krogan virility and aggression. Ryder, attached is my Krogan thesis that I mentioned to you. I know, only 500 pages, but I wasn't allowed to go over. If you get through it, I wrote a longer dissertation for the Citadel Journal of Medicine, around 1,400 pages, that's much more insightful and includes mating diagrams. Lexi. Yoga poses from Lexi. Ryder, given the amount of high-impact cardio in your exercise routine, I recommend spending 5 to 10 minutes a day stretching to open your hips and relieve tightness in the lower back. The poses I've listed below should do nicely. Not to sound elitist, but while it's true humans invented yoga, the Asari perfected it. Currents bow. Standing, spread your legs apart, turning 1 foot outwards. Take a deep breath. On exhale, bend your torso towards the outward facing foot until your hand meets your ankle. Hold for 5 seconds, then switch sides. Tavura's embrace. Lying on your back, bring your feet together until there is a diamond of negative space between your legs. Palms against the floor, push your hips forward, but be careful not to overextend yourself. Matriarch's pose. Kneeling, take a deep breath. On exhale, bring both hands together to form a triangle. On the second inhale, swing arms overhead and bend forward until your torso is between your thighs. Hold for 3 breaths, reaching farther with each exhale. Please let me know if you need diagrams or vids. Lexi. Data cores. From Peebee. Hey, Ryder. Hope it's okay that I'm keeping this data core in my room, i.e. the escape pod. I guess I just really like to ponder things before bed. The best ideas come to me while I'm half asleep. Also, I saw it first. Anyway, we know for sure it's got some sort of data in it. The trick is how to get at it. I'll keep you updated, PB. All I had before was... interviews. So I wonder now that we've... Can I talk to her more about her spirituality and PB about the data core thing?
Ryder.
Maybe not.
I should get back to things. Sounds good?
Mm-mm. What awkwardness. So I can ask her about this data thing.
Hey there. Got a sec? Sure.
This is highlighted again.
I like it when you flirt. I wouldn't want you to stop. Have I flirted with you? Don't worry, Ryder. I'm relentless. It relaxes me.
Good God.
Thanks for chatting. We'll talk again later.
You know it.
She's like way too awkward and cute at the same time. I don't know if there's anyone back here. No. Okay. We can change our loadout, I believe, over there. Long crew update. Wow.